What is zoo? Pimpin'. Oh boy. Hey, yay. What y'all know about a hey? Don't put that in there.
How is it lifting so fast?
I don't know.
Do you have magic hair?
Magic as in it's probably gonna fall off when you rinse it.
It's disappearing. Ha ha. Get it?
Yeah.
What's up, guys? So I just started with crushing up 16 500 milligram vitamin C tablets, or you can just go and buy the vitamin C powder if you can find it. I just use like a little pill crusher to crush up the pills, and you're gonna mix it with anti-dandruff shampoo, kind of like Head and Shoulders. I used a little over half the amount of shampoo compared to powder, and it's gonna give you this like kind of thick consistency. And then I just started with damp hair, and you're just gonna apply the mixture all over your hair. Basically, it's not as harsh as bleach is, so it's okay if you get it on new growth or anything like that. It won't make your new growth a different color than your hair. This is just to get some of my hair coloring out that I already have. And you're pretty much just gonna massage that all over in your hair really nicely. It's not like you normally shampoo your hair, like you want to get really in there. And whenever you have it all over, like I said, you just start massaging it. And then after that, you're gonna take section by section and slowly start just working it in with your hands. As you can see, I'm just working in each section and then putting it off to the side, so I know I'm getting all the bits and pieces. Just keep working it in there until your arms want to fall off. You can see my arms want to fall off. And then you're done with that, and then you would I just put a shower cap on so it didn't get anywhere, and then I let that process for 22 minutes, then I rinsed it out and conditioned it because it can be pretty drying to your hair, and this is the result to that. Next, I did a bleach bath so it wouldn't be as damaging to my hair. To make a bleach bath, you would just use one part bleach, one part developer, and one part shampoo. I used a 20 volume developer, a random daily shampoo that I just found laying around, and the bleach I used you can only purchase if you're a licensed cosmetologist like I am, so I suggest Wella or Quick Blue, which are both at Sally's if you don't have your license. So here you just see me mixing 1-to-1 ratios of everything and then just mixing it all together. It's going to create a much thinner base than bleach normally would. Then once again, you're going to start on damp hair. And as you can see, all she's doing is putting it on my ends and then kind of working it up with her fingers. I wanted her to focus on my ends because I had new growth and I didn't want the new growth to lighten more than my ends would. Also, I just wanted kind of some highlights on the ends. So throughout the video, you just see her working it in, which a bleach bath is good to work in because it helps make it process faster. So as you can see, she's just working it in slowly and just moving it up the hair so it blends better and it's not just a harsh line. And then she's going to use the comb to pretty much do the same thing, just blending it upwards. And I let this process for only 15 minutes because my hair does not take to bleach well and I didn't want to damage it too much. So as you can see, she's still just working it in until we get to the desired blonde we want. And this is it after we rinse it. And this is the hair color whenever it's dry. I basically just parted my hair into four sections to get it ready for dyeing it blue. So next I use Manic Panic's Rockabilly Blue and a little bit of just a plain white conditioner. And I just mixed it all together. I used the whole jar of the Manic Panic because I was kind of scared of running out. And I only had a little bit left. So if you have much longer hair than me, then I would suggest buying probably about two or three Manic Panics, not just one. And first I just put the color all along the perimeter of each section, and then I slowly just started taking a little section by section and making sure it was all very saturated. Don't be scared, like I use a lot of hair color for like each section. That's why you want to make sure you have extra of the color, because you want everything to be fully saturated. And I pretty much just applied it all over the head, as you'll be able to see. It's very simple. I find it's easier using a coloring brush to do the job and then work it through with your hands, but I mean, everyone's different. So, and once again, after I was done each section, I pretty much just put it up in like a little space bun or a clip or whatever, and to get them out the way. And I let this process for 3 hours, and then I rinsed it and shampooed it out with cold water. And whenever I say cold water, I'm talking about ice cold water. And yeah, now I'm just gonna let the music play.
Hey guys, okay, so I wanted to put this in because I'm probably not going to film the next step, but I also didn't want y'all to think that after I rinsed out the blue dye, everything was fine, because to me, it wasn't. I have blue fingers and blue scalp, but that's fine. After I rinsed out the blue, you can't see it on camera, but I have
about half an inch of new growth, and that came out like a blue black. And then I have about an inch and a half of red still in my hair, and then it goes to blue. So tomorrow or sometime, I'm going to find some kind of blue black hair dye, probably like demi permanent, and put it just on my roots where it would cover the red so I don't have to see it. Like, you don't notice it in this lighting, but in other lightings you can see it, and it bothers me. So just putting it in here that I'm going to be doing that step, but I'm not going to be filming it because I am most likely not going to do it myself. So, because I'm lazy. Now I should be showing you the final thing. Look, it is different colors and different lightings. In this lighting, it's more of like a blue black, I guess you can say. In other lightings, you could really see like the blue highlights in it, and in the sun you can see it's more of a bright blue, the ends are. But unfortunately, I didn't get to get any footage in the sun because it's been very gloomy and rainy around here. So I didn't get to get any footage in the sun. So this will just have to do. Thank y'all so much for watching. Give it a thumbs up if y'all would like to see more videos where I transform hair colors. Obviously, I can't do it all to myself because my hair will fall off, but I can always do it to other people. I love doing colorful hair and what not. Comment down below which crazy hair color you would like to dye your hair if you ever could. Any color on your hair, what color would it be? And if you want to support me and become part of my family and whatnot, hit that subscribe button because I want to make this more of like a full-time thing, not just like an oh I post every Sunday thing. So hit that subscribe button, help me out, support me. Yeah, thank y'all again so much, and see y'all next time. Rob Stone, two damn phones, Babylon.